Let us begin with the first step of financial modeling. The first step of financial model is to get the historical data. We should try to get minimum 3 to max 5 years of data. This is just a general thing, but models are also prepared when there is no historical data available. But for this case study, on your screen you can see we have 3 years of income statement and 3 years of historical balance sheet, and we have to prepare a financial model based on this historical data only. Here the idea is to understand where the model start and how to prepare various schedules and how the model will end. In this case study, we will make the projections of all the items of income statement and all the items of balance sheet with the help of various schedules. In the first step, major line items are calculated, like sales and COGS are taken from the annual report and gross profit will be calculated. Likewise, SG&A, others and SBC are taken from the annual report and EBITDA will be calculated. Depreciation and amortization are taken from the annual report, EBIT will be calculated. So let us first begin with gross profit. Put an equal here, take sales minus COGS, enter. Highlight the range, press Ctrl R. Now put an equal here to calculate EBITDA. Gross profit minus SG&A expense minus other income. Other income is written in minus, so when you put minus before other income, it will be added. Minus stock based compensation, enter. Highlight the range, press Ctrl R. Now there is another way to do it. Select the range first, put an equal, EBITDA minus depreciation minus amortization. Now press Ctrl Enter. If you press Ctrl Enter, the highlighted range will have the same formula. Press Ctrl Enter and see what happens. We have the same formula in all the three cells. Now select the range again, put an equal, take EBIT minus interest expense, press Ctrl Enter, select the range, equal, pre-tax income minus income taxes, Ctrl Enter. Next we have retained earning. To calculate retained earning, what we need to do, we need to minus reserves, common dividend, preferred dividend and DDT on common dividend and DDT on preferred dividend. What is DDT? DDT is dividend distribution tax. So put in equal here, take net income minus sum of reserves, comma, and these four items, bracket close. Now press enter, highlight the range, press Ctrl R. Now we have basic EPS, diluted EPS and dividend per share. The formula to calculate basic earning per share is PAT attributable to ordinary equity shares divided by basic weighted average shares. To calculate PAT attributable to ordinary equity shareholder, we need to deduct preferred dividend and dividend distribution tax on preferred dividend from net income. So put in equal, open the bracket, take net income minus preferred dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preferred stock dividend, bracket close, divide this by basic weighted average shares. Press enter, select the range, press Ctrl R. Now next we have diluted earning per share. To calculate diluted earning per share, we assume that diluted securities are converted into ordinary equity shares at the beginning of the year. And diluted securities are options, warrants, convertible preferred stock and convertible debt. When we assume preferred stock will be converted into ordinary shares, then we do not have to pay preferred dividend. So this time we will not deduct preferred dividend and we will take net income directly and divide this by diluted weighted average shares. Enter, select the range, press Ctrl R. Now we have dividend per share. So put in equal, take common dividend and divide this by shares outstanding, select the range, press Ctrl R. So this was the first step that we have just performed. Now the next step is to do the historical analysis of the income statement. And historical analysis we will do in the next video.